Hello students, welcome to the second part of the chapter Weather, Climate and Adaptations. Let's start today's session. We'll start with benefits of weather forecasting. We'll see how this weather forecasting is beneficial for us. The first point is weather forecasting allows people to prepare for bad weather, which means in case suppose if there is prediction of cyclone, people who are living near seashore can take the help of weather forecast and can move to safer areas. This way weather forecasting is helpful for them. Second point, it is helpful to protect life and property. People can save their life and property if they are warned against some natural calamities like hurricane or heavy shower, etc. The third point is, it is helpful to plan activities and events. Generally, it is helpful in planning outdoor activities. At number four, it helps farmers to plan various agricultural activities. With the help of weather forecasting, farmers can plan when to sow the seeds till and when to plow the field or when to harvest the crops. All such activities depend on the weather forecasting. The next topic is climate. Let's see what is climate. It is the average weather condition at a particular place over a long period of time. And climate varies from place to place. To determine the climate of a place, meteorologists maintain the record of everyday weather. Then the average maximum and minimum temperatures are calculated. The study of climate is called as climatology. The next topic is geographical factors affecting the climate. The climate of a place is determined by the following factors, and the factors are the latitude or distance from the equator, that is the first one. Second is distance from the sea. Third is humidity and rainfall. And fourth is altitude or height above the sea level. The first is latitude or distance from the equator. Distance of a place from the equator is represented by latitude. You all know that the equator receives maximum sunlight and the sun rays fall straight on the equator. Therefore, whatever the places in the equatorial region and nearby are very warm and have maximum rainfall. As we move away from the equator on either side towards the pole, the angle of sun rays increases. As this is because you all know that the earth is tilted at an angle of 23.5 degree over there. So that is why when we move away from the equator on either side toward the pole, the angle of sun rays increases. That is, the sun rays become slanting, as you can see in the diagram also, which decreases the intensity of light and heat. Here you can see the places which are at the equatorial region are receiving the maximum sun rays over here. And that is why the places which are at the equatorial region are having very high temperature and humid climate. Therefore, the distance from the equator determines the climate of a place. Children, if you are at the equatorial region, you will experience the very warm and humid type of climate. But as you move towards the poles, you will experience a bit change in the climate. That is, the climate becomes cooler. Places which are near and farther from the equator have different temperatures because of the angle at which the sun rays strike the earth's surface. So, the latitude or the distance from the equator determines the climate of a place. Based on the differences in temperature and rainfall, three climatic zones have been identified. Here you can see the three different zones are marked. One is the red, green and blue. Let's take one by one. The first zone is the torrid zone. This torrid zone is also called as the tropical zone. As you can see in the diagram, the red zone represents the tropical zone, which is also called as the torrid zone. Let's learn something about this torrid zone. That is, these zones are the hot and humid zones around the equator. They get direct and straight sun rays throughout the year, and they have tropical evergreen forests. Moving on to the next zone, that is the frigid zone, that is the polar zones, which are marked with the blue color at the North Pole and the South Pole. These zones are the regions around the North and South Poles, and they receive slanting sun rays and are very cold, and they have grasses, mosses and small shrubs in the form of vegetation. The third kind of temperate zone, the third kind of zone is the temperate zone. These zones lie between torrid and frigid zones, and they have grasslands and few trees only. With this, we come to the end of today's session. The rest of the topics will be covered in the next part of the video. Thank you.